Another in our series of what's that button do? You've all looked at cassette decks. I wonder what those buttons do. Well, this one is the bias button, the bias knob, the bias switch. What does it do? Bias tune on this one. So what does it actually do? Is it necessary? Why is it some of them have them, some don't? This is on a Sony. This is on a Sony 2-head. This is on a Sony 3-head. Oh, look, there's bias on something else. And this is on another one. This is on a Technics, and that's on a Technics. ATC. What's it all about? I'll tell you, but I'll try and keep it simple. But before I do, I want you to see this. This is a cassette deck. It's a 2-head, as it happens. And it's got bias control, which you can see on the right-hand side there, just above the sausage fingers. And you can see there it's actually showing levels, and now it's showing it's the top one's a bit higher than the bottom one. Well, what we've got on there is we've got a playback of a recording, and so one channel's got high frequency being fed to it, the other one's got low frequency being fed to it, and the whole point of the bias control is to adjust it so that they both come in at the same level, thereby meaning you've got a flat response on the tape. Because this was a 2-head machine, you had to record it and alter it as you were recording it, and then play back to see what the effects were, and that's what I'm showing you there. With a 3-head machine, of course, you could actually alter it and see it as it alters. But with a 2-head, you've got to go back and play it back, which is easy enough and is no big deal. Don't forget, though, what you're seeing there is a complete range from one end to the other. So actually, from the center detent point, which is in the middle, you're not looking at that big a difference between one end and the other. Just from one end to the other, there's a big difference. I'm going to read you some words in a minute. They're going to run out the screen. Is bias adjustment necessary? No, it is not. Bias is set to a standard. Tapes are made to that standard. So why do we have bias adjusters? In the 80s and 90s, tape standards, bit of a pause, big breath, and here we go, were improved. The tolerances were widened for manufacturing reasons. This meant that the machines could best use the tape from different makers if they could be fine-tuned. So that's what the knob's for, is for fine-tuning. The makers aimed for all the standards, but for the sort of reason cannot hit exactly. High-end decks added a new feature that could be charged for. Calibration. Tape calibration. Is it worth it? Yes. Is it a deal-breaker? No. The adjustment is small. The benefit is small. If your deck suits the tapes, there's no need to use it. The Sony you just watched being adjusted has not got tones to set it with. The best way is to show in the video. Without tones, just set to the default mark. Calibration is good, not vital. If you use a good branded tape, you will get good results. If you try a no-name and a Dragon could be set for it and you get accepted results, why did you buy a Dragon for £1,000 or dollars and buy cheap tapes? So what that means is that if you haven't got a bias control, you don't need one. And if you've got one, you can fine-tune it. But at the end of the day, most tapes will play, most machines, properly. Well, it's not playing, actually, it's recording. And that's all that you've got to worry about. If the tape you've got doesn't suit your machine, there's no guarantee having a bias adjustment control will make it suit. And if it does, you might not like the sound anyway. So, end of the day, quite simply, get a tape that plays and records nicely in your machine, and that's it, sorted. The bias tuning and the automatic level, ATC, automatic tape calibration, and the other buttons that are similarly marked, they're of no real importance other than the fact that what they do is you push the button, it runs the tape through, it then calibrates it and it does it all itself. So what you saw me doing on the Sony, it will do automatically for you. It will record a patch, rewind it, and then it will adjust itself to suit. But that's on the really posh machines, be them 2-head or 3-head. And if you haven't got one, well, like I say, you don't really need it. Just find a tape that works. So I hope you got some value out of that. If you've got any queries, any questions, or if you want to try and have a discussion, then please do so in the comments below. And in the meantime, hit the subscribe button, hit the bell, and I'll catch you another time. Cheers.